You could speak to people in the cradle, and when you were fully grown. Remember when God said, Jesus, Son of Mary, remember my blessing to you and to your mother when I reinforced you with the purest spirit so that you could speak to people in the cradle and when you were fully grown. He will speak to people in the cradle and also when fully grown and will be one of the righteous. Ka-lan, which is used only in these two verses, only in reference to Jesus, and to express Jesus' adulthood means someone between the age of 30 and 50, someone who is no longer young, someone who has reached the perfect age. Islamic scholars agree that it denotes the age of 35 or above. Yet, based on hadiths, they state that Jesus was raised up to God's presence in his early 30s. Therefore, the Prophet Jesus did not reach the age of Ka'lan during his first life. This may also indicate that he will return again to earth and live a second life. In the commentary of At-Tabari, Imam At-Tabari gives the following explanation of these verses. These statements indicate that in order to complete his lifespan and speak to people when fully grown, Jesus will come down from heaven. That is because he was raised to heaven when still young. Jesus will be recognized by the fact that he will have no relatives and that no one will know him. In Surah 3, verse 45, God informs us that the Prophet Jesus is of high esteem in the world and the hereafter, and one of those brought near. Thus, like all the prophets, Jesus will be known to those people surrounding him for the honor and excellence only seen in those chosen by God. Those who see him will recognize him at first sight, and there will be no doubt on this matter in their hearts. Apart from these, there will also be other factors disclosing his identity. No doubt, one of them will be the fact that he will have no relatives, family, or acquaintances on earth. Not a single person will come out and say, I have known him before, I saw him when. These people are his family and relatives, simply because the people who knew him lived and died about 2,000 years ago. There is no doubt but that this criterion will invalidate the baseless claims of the false messiahs who will appear from time to time. Because it is most illogical for someone who spent all his childhood among people, and who has been known to countless people ever since, to claim that he is the Prophet Jesus. When the Prophet Jesus returns to earth, on the other hand, there will be no doubt as to his identity. Nobody will have any reason to say, this person cannot be the Prophet Jesus, because the Prophet Jesus will return in the same form that he was raised into the sight of God, wearing the same clothes, and will possess superior features that no human being can possibly imitate. The proof so clearly revealed in the Quran and the developments being experienced on earth impart the most glad and holy tidings. It is certain that the Prophet Jesus will return to earth in the end times and will lead people to Islam, the true religion. This is great news for everyone on earth and a source of joy and enthusiasm. The coming of the Prophet Jesus is a blessing from God for all mankind, because with that coming, all the chaos on earth will come to an end. The moral values of the Quran will prevail everywhere, and the most superior age in all regards will begin. What we must do is to prepare for that glorious day in the finest manner possible, and welcome this holy prophet in the best way on his return. Indeed, God commands us Muslims to be like the disciples who assisted the Prophet Jesus. You who believe, be helpers of God as Jesus, son of Mary, said to the disciples, "Who will be my helpers to God?" The disciples said, "We will be the helpers of God." One faction of the tribe of Israel believed and the other disbelieved. So we supported those who believed against their enemy, and they became victorious.